Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today I'll give you a brief overview of the Cryptostegia madagascarensis and grandiflora. I am a SANBI student working with the University of Victoria. We are looking at Cryptostegia grandiflora and madagascarensis, and they are two very similar species. Most of the time quite difficult to distinguish between the two. We have found that one of the more reliable ways to distinguish between the two species is by looking at the flowers. As you can see on the right-hand side, you see madagascarensis has got a purple flower, definitely purple, where grandiflora on the other side is a bigger and white flower. Both these species are native to the drier areas of Madagascar. They are vigorous climbers that can scramble up into even the tallest trees or anything that they can find. It's a very powerful seed dispersal with wind and water, and it's originally introduced into South Africa as ornamental plant. We often find the plants in rural areas and gardens as either a self-supporting multi-stem shrub or growing as a hedge along the fence, as you can see on the photo here. In Australia, this plant has caused a lot of damage, especially in grazing pastures in northern Queensland, where it's invaded thousands of hectares and caused damage to an amount of hundreds and thousands of dollars. Wherever the plant grows, it kills native plants. And often where it grows, it causes dense thickets, and that limits access to water or pastures. It's been listed as a weed of national significance in Australia and one of the world's most invasive horticultural plants. It's always been also been reported in South America, Asia, and the USA and Africa. Both these species have been reported in South Africa. Where it occurs in natural areas, the plants have become highly invasive. These are just examples of two geographic maps of grandiflora, and you can see the distribution is very wide across the globe. The same for madagascarensis. In South Africa, we're still continuing gathering occurrence records, and there's not a lot yet at the moment. One of the areas that we have found grandiflora is in the northern, northwestern part of the Limpopo River along the Mogalakwena River. In pilot density survey studies that we did in 2013 along a 7.2 kilometer stretch of the Mogalakwena River, we found that the plants prefer to be close to permanent water supplies, as you can see indicated by the dams in the river. Where you see one little spot on the end, that's where there's a natural barrier where water stays behind when the river is dry. Our next step is to look at possible variables that can possibly influence the fine scale distribution of madagascarensis and grandiflora. At Mogalakwena River, we will be looking at soil moisture, soil type, soil depth, and erosion, and so forth, what can possibly influence the distribution. One of our next steps is then also to experimentally test four management options. Based on work that was done in Australia, we will mainly be looking at fire, mechanical, chemical, and then a combination of fire and chemical and mechanical. As Ian Patterson earlier said today, that fighting or controlling vines is very tough, and hopefully in the future we'll be looking at fire control as a long-term solution to Cryptostegia infestations.